Good day, my dear sixth class students. I am very happy to continue this lesson, Peace and Harmony. Two or three sessions we had. I explained the whole lesson with the spellings, pronunciation, the meaning, the moral. Today, just before starting, I got an idea. Why don't I tell the story in the form of a flow diagram? Now you know what is a flow diagram. It's a diagram that lists all the activities as they occur. Avi elaga jarigayo adenu cheptaru. That way it becomes like a story. And here, of course, this is a story. So I want to explain the lesson in the form of a story. Then, of course, the previous class, I requested you to read the lesson 3 times with understanding, not mere reading. Now, students, my dear children, not mere reading does not help. If you are reading a sentence, if you complete reading a sentence, move on to the next sentence, that means you know the meaning of the previous sentence. That's how you have to proceed. If you do that 1 or 2 times, you understand the lesson 100%. Anybody ask anything in that lesson, you'll be very easily answered that. So it's very important. So I hope you read that, you made that, you fulfilled that requirement. That means reading the lesson 3 times. Then of course we have the questions and answers, and then I pick the textual grammar. I felt it is necessary that I should go over the lesson one more time, because there may be a little bit of confusion. Or lack of, let's say, instead of the word confusion, lack of clear understanding. I thought that I will go over the lesson in the form of a flow diagram. It's wonderful. I got this idea. I never prepared for this before we wanted to record it. When I came here and to the blackboard, then I realized, oh my God, Jana, how did you forget this? You should be able to explain the lesson very easily in the form of a flow diagram. And even the student having the most difficulty understanding, he can easily follow the flow diagram very well. So let me, with that little bit of introduction, let me move on. So, once upon a time, there was a thick forest, and there are several animals in it. Animals like elephants, tigers, and monkeys, pythons, like that. They're all very happy. In the second one, they're all very happy. How do you know they're happy? They're singing, dancing, and roaming. And they're having some musical nights. But the musical nights, who are the guests of honor? Do you remember? Moon, yes. Moon and the stars. They are the guests of honor. They were enjoying, singing, dancing, roaming, without any fear. A deer is not afraid of a tiger. So like that. Then what happened is, here, this is all the good part of it. Now, a jackal enters the forest. It looks at all the animals. It thinks that, hey, I got a good supply of food here, so it tried to attack small animals, and it could not. Everybody is jumping on the jackal or the fox. So then it thought about a plan. I want to divide them. So that's what it did. It created the differences among the animals. Then what happened? Animals are divided. Each one has its own boundary. Nobody bothered what is happening to the other animal. So what happened? That is the time when the jackal jumped onto the animal, small animal, started eating one after another. Then the animals realized hey, this cattle is eating us, and we are the forest is depleting. Thank you for the Lord. Depleting. So they were very, very, very sad. And there are no more musical nights. What happened is there are no more musical nights. That means there is no more moon singing, dancing or anything. So the moon observed, hey, what is happening here in the forest? Earlier, all these animals are, you know, they are dancing and or singing and all kinds of things are there. We are the guests of honor. We enjoy it. And now there is no enjoyment. What happened? Then the moon understood, hey, what is happening. Then moon cannot come here and help them. So what did moon do? Moon sent sadhu, a saint, sadhu, saint, and the saint came to the forest. As soon as the saint came, all the animals gathered and started telling their own horrible stories. Oh, I lost my chicken, I lost my baby, I lost my... This jackal is eating our children, small children, like that. Then sadhu, what did sadhu do? He held several meetings with all some animals. And finally, while this is going on, all the animals had an emergency meeting. And then they requested the sadhu to kill the jackal or the fox. So sadhu told them, hey guys, don't worry. I don't kill the dog, fox, but I have another plan. Okay, all right. As long as we are safe, as long as we can go back to the old lifestyle, that is the dancing and roaming without any fear, having a friendly relationship with all the animals, that's all what we want. So what happened is, one day, the fox went to a chicks place to eat them, eat the chicks for supper. So there, sadhu was staying there. That's what it is, moon sadhu and listening, I told you that. Sadhu had meetings, I told you that. Then the emergency meeting, I told that. Then the jackal eating sadhu, that's the next one. So what happened is, sadhu said to the fox, Father told the fox, that hey, don't eat the chicks, eat me. My God, jackal thought, oh my God, wonderful. Because jackal is thinking of somehow killing the sadhu. Because of the sadhu, he is not able to eat the other animals. So he thought, my God, wonderful opportunity to kill the sadhu. So what happened that day? The fox took the sadhu to a lonely place. He dragged him to a lonely place, tear him apart, and started eating. Okay, then all the animals, seeing that, they were very unhappy. My God, why did we hear sadhu is our guest? Because of us, he is being eaten by the fox. It's very bad. We did a wrong thing. Then suddenly, there was a loud noise. Then everybody went up. What is happening here? So everybody went and tried to see what is happening there. There, what they saw, they were shocked. They were surprised to see what was happening there. What is happening is, the fox eating the sadhu and its stomach or belly got bigger and bigger and bigger. Finally, it burst and the fox died. Then sadhu comes to all the animals. Hey guys, now jackal is not there anymore. Fox is not there anymore. You get back to your old style. Invite the moon. Invite the stars. Have your musical night and all that. That is the summary of the story. So you understand, once upon a time, all the animals were very happy, dancing and roaming and singing and all that. Then a jackal comes, splits them apart, and no more dances, nothing. So the moon sees that, and the whole forest is slept. Then moon sends the sadhu. Sadhu had meetings with all the animals, and then one day when these animals requested sadhu to kill the jackal, sadhu came up with a plan and offered himself as a prey, as a food for the fox. Fox ate the sadhu and it could not hold it in the stomach. So the stomach got bigger and bigger and bigger, and it finally burst and finally died. So that is how the jackal, the fox, which tried to divide the animals, finally passed away. And the sadhu helped that way, and then usually they had their own meetings and all that. So the whole story, like I said in the beginning, it centers around the famous writer, Paravastu Chennayeswari, wonderful man, a great man, great writer. He wrote so many books. Out of which, when somebody, like I said, somebody talks about Paravastu Chennayeswari, they remember about Neeti Chandrika. Neeti Chandrika. That means Neeti. Neeti means what? More. You know that, right? Neeti Chandran Kanyada. So, Neeti Chandrika Andhuran, son, Mitra Labham, Mitra Bhadam. Here, earlier, Mitra Labham, and they are all having good time. They are everybody enjoying it. That's the benefit they got. And then they are separated, then you have the Bhadam and all that. So, that is the summary of the story, guys. And hereafter, you should not have any more doubt about what happened when, what were the words used. In the previous times when I taught, I explained all the vocabulary, the way to pronounce and all that, okay? So lesson teaching with this class is over. You should understand every bit of the lesson. Of course, you know, if you did not understand, Janathape is always there. I am always there. Srijana Vidyalaya is always there. It takes care of all the children. This is not a monetary institution. We want the children to grow. So, if you have doubt, like I told you, you can write a comment at the bottom of this presentation, or the best thing is write on a piece of paper, send it by WhatsApp. Okay, now let's move on. Now, yesterday, or in the previous lesson, I talked to you about the questions and answers. We took three or four questions, and once you read the lesson, I would like you to come up with your own answers. That means answers in your own words. Now that is what we believe in Srijana Vidyalaya. We don't want you to by heart any answer. You have to understand the lesson. Once you understand the lesson, you can easily come up with the answer. So, for example, I would like to tell you, I am not going to go about all the questions. Once you understood and once you prepare your own answers, you can check yourself, or you can check, send by WhatsApp, and we will check and let you know. So, you know very well, a lot of the, except for the newcomers to Srijana, every student knows how to convert a question into an answer. How to convert a question into an answer. For example, what did the sadhu teach the animals in the forest? What did the sadhu teach the animals in the forest? The sadhu did teach, then what did they want to taught. The sadhu taught the following to the animals. And Chepi, Indian Chepi, 1, 2, 3. That's what he does. Similarly, for example, how was the moon disguised? How was the moon disguised? Disguised in the Vasa Dharitra. Moon allowed Chimli Yatsuki in the form of a sadhu. So, how was the moon disguised? That means you have to say, the moon was disguised as Yadhyanti Nichari Lenti. Paramatna Arthaipin Jala ఎలా వచ్చింది, మూన్ ఎలా వచ్చింది, సాజ్ రూపంలో వచ్చింది. సో ద మూన్ ఇస్ డిస్గైజ్డ్ యాజ్ సాధు. సో దట్స్ వై ఈజీ, యు నో ది, యు డోంట్ హ్యావ్ టు బై హార్ట్ దిస్ క్వశ్చన్ అండ్ ఆన్సర్, రైట్? సో ఇఫ్ యు నో అండర్స్టాండింగ్ ది లెసన్ సెంటెన్స్ బై సెంటెన్స్ ఇస్ సో ఇంపార్టెంట్, దెన్ వాట్ అబౌట్ ది అదర్ వన్? What happened to the animals after the jackal came to the forest? After the jackal came to the forest, what happened to the animals? The thing that happened to the animals after the jackal came is as follows. And what is as follows? All as follows. Yeah, question, question. That's okay. And then why okay? Because why did the sadhu ask the jackal to take him for his meal? Why did the sadhu ask the jackal to take him for his meal? So in answering it, the jackal, the sadhu asked the jackal to take him for his meal because question in answer to why is Sanjabati? Because Ravan. Because of the following. Period. Then you write down the answer and all that. So now you understand how to prepare the answers to the questions. Now, for example, and also, if you look at page 5, there is a list of how many? 12 events that happened in this story. 12 events that happened in the story. Now here, what they say is, you have to put these 12 events in an order. The same thing here, here, this is a flow diagram, here you are going to put the order. And when you write the order, you can even change the numbers in the order they happen, or rewrite the sentences, then it becomes a good story. Like that, you have some items here. Now, in this, I have completed the questions and answers. Prerequisites, I asked you about it, and recapitulation by in the form of a flow diagram I did, and then textual grammar, I'm going to talk about the degrees of comparison and also the opposite words in this lesson. Some of you know the degrees of comparison and also the opposite words. Opposite words, you also call it as antonyms, 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 and then opposite word and synonyms, synonyms, synonyms means the meaning, similar meanings, that is called synonyms. And this one is the opposite meaning. This is a similar meaning. This is the opposite meaning. So, for example, and then prior to this, I also told you that I am going to touch about adjectives. Adjectives and degrees of comparison. Now, adjective is a word that qualifies a noun. Rama is a good boy. Rama is the best boy in the class. Rama is better than any boy in the class. He got a good, better, and best. Those are the adjectives. So, similarly, you may have smallest. Kind, kinder, kindest. Dirty, dirtiest, dirtiest, melodious, more melodious, and most melodious. And then, when you want to express a particular quality, first of all, adjective qualifies a what? Noun. Adjective qualifies a noun. When you qualify, you can qualify in three different ways. One in the positive degree, Second one is the comparative degree. Third one is the superlative degree. The Ganges is the holiest river in the world, or in India. The Ganges is the holiest river in India. Okay? There are several rivers in India. Out of all those rivers, Ganges, Ganganade, Ganges is considered to be the holiest. Similarly, Krishna is the best boy in the class. That means he gets the maximum number of marks, best boy in the class, best student in the class. So, most obedient student in the class, like that. So, these are all the adjectives that describe the noun. So, here we talked about dark, darker, darkest, small, smaller, smallest, big, bigger, biggest, lovely, lovelier, loveliest, dirty, dirtier, and dirtiest. So in the next class, I will tell you how the adjectives, for several adjectives, how do you find the different forms. One is a positive degree form, another one is a comparative degree form, another one is the superlative degree form. In all these things, like I said, good, better, best. Best is the superlative. Better is the comparative. And good is the positive. Like that. For different words, how do you find the different forms? Some forms, like for example, dark. You have dark, darker, darkest. So ER, if you add ER to the dark, you get comparative degree. Then you have EST. If you add that, then it becomes superlative degree. So, tomorrow or the next class, I will explain to you, I will have a concept map. Take the adjective, how that a specific adjective, specific adjective, will have the positive degree form, a comparative degree form, and a superlative degree form. So, we learned a little bit about an adjective and its three forms, positive, comparative, superlative. Tomorrow, like I told you, our next lesson, I will tell you, with the help of a concept map, how different forms of the adjectives can be found by making some modifications. Okay? I don't want to go in detail tomorrow or the next class. Here is the best opportunity for me to explain with the help of a concept map. Similarly, we have called, like I told you here, antonyms and synonyms. Antonym and opposite words. And we generally use the word opposite words. Antonym is not that commonly used, but that is the right word. Antonym and synonym. Synonym means having the same meaning or similar meaning. Whereas antonym is antonym is the opposite meaning. Say, for example, you have several examples here. Big, small, dark, light, happy, unhappy, large, small, live, die, long, short, near, far. These are all the words for which, they are listed in your textbook. You can see that. Again, once again, when you want to find the opposites or the antonyms, there is also, we can make a concept map. That's very easy. That will tell you the whole story, how to find an antonym. In certain cases, the word completely changes. In certain cases, you make some small modifications, then you will get the antonym. For example, I will tell you, faithful. That one is, suppose you want an antonym for that, all you do is add unfaithful. Now, suppose if you take the word good, G-O-O-D, good. Good, what is the opposite of good? Here, the word completely changes. Good and bad. Similarly, kind. The word completely changes. It is cruel. Say, faithful, unfaithful. Possible, impossible. So there are some cases, there are some techniques. Chittalantam, techniques. How to find an antonym? In certain cases, the word completely changes. In certain cases, you make a small modification. Either you take out some letters or add some letters. By that, you will get the antonyms. So, my dear friends, in this part four, like I said here, the repatriation or a brief review, which I did that with the help of a flow diagram. Then I again questioned. I asked you, I wanted to find out whether really you read the lesson with understanding. I told you, when you are reading, if one lesson is complete, one sentence, when you complete one sentence, move on to the next sentence. You should have complete understanding of the previous sentence. Till you understand that sentence completely, do not move on to the next sentence. Then you end up nowhere. If you don't follow this procedure, you end up nowhere. So, important, whatever sentence you don't understand, stop there. Take a photo, send it to Janathapaya. He will take care of that. He'll make a phone call or write on a piece of paper and answer. So, reading, very important. Reading for the sake of reading, no, please don't do that. Please do not do that. When you sit to read the lesson, if not only this subject, any subject, when you want to do a problem, put your 100%. Now when you go to Bahubali cinema, when you are watching the movie, do you think of the maths homework? Or do you think of what your mother is preparing for dinner in the kitchen? You don't. You put your 100% on the movie. How is it you are able to remember most of the dialogues? You hear only one time you are hearing. But when you come out of the theater, you can tell a lot of the dialogues. That is because of concentration. So, and dedication. So, when you are reading, it's very important. That's why it's called a reading comprehension. That means when you read a paragraph or a sentence, you have to make sure that you understand the sentence. If you don't understand the sentence, stop there. Take somebody's help. Alright, you cannot stop every time. So, let us say you did not understand a particular sentence. Draw a line with a pencil on that and then summarize them, maybe three or four sentences like that. Send it to Sridhara Vidyalaya. Sridhara Vidyalaya is there 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. Okay? You don't have to worry. You know, in the past, some of the parents know, when they send me a question, in the night at 10:15, they have the answer at 10:30. So we love, when a student asks a question, we love to answer. I mean, not for every question, I may not know the answer, but I have all the tools. If I don't know, I have several scholars that I know. I will talk to them. Above and beyond, all these scholars, there is one scholar, Google. If I go to Google, if I ask the right question, I will get several answers with several examples. I have the tools. And more importantly, we are dedicated, we are determined to teach the student. Okay? So student, I am very happy that we are coming to an end of this lesson. If you will read it very well, in the part 5, I may try to close it. Or maybe one more, part 6, maybe part 6. See, in the following lessons, we will take less time. This is a prose. Poetry also will take less time. It takes less time. Whereas prose will take a little bit more time. There is always a first time. First time, this is the first time we are doing. So, first lesson. So, it will take a little bit more time. And also a little bit more time for you to, you know, catch up with us. So, do it. We are here to help you. Thanks for watching my video. If you like it, share it. Thank you very much.